Hi all, let us begin to the next session on PCM and quantization. PCM refers to pulse code modulation. So the pulse code modulation, it is a class of baseband signals which is after quantizing the pulse amplitude modulated signals by encoding those quantized samples into digital world, we are going to get the pulse code modulated signal. So we have already seen how to obtain this PCM waveform in the previous session on quantization. The source information is sampled and quantized to one of L levels, which we have seen already. So the same thing we'll be looking in today, and we will also learn about in depth on what is called as quantization. Quantization, it is a non-linear transformation which maps elements from a continuous signal into a finite set of values. So we are looking into such kind of finite sets of values to be mapped for each and individual analog signal which is available for us. So if we look at the basic building block of the digital communication system, this is the very second step which is required by analog to digital conversion block. So in analog to digital conversion block, the analog signal is first sampled, converted into discrete time, and then quantized, and finally we will get the output as the digital signal, which will be a discrete timed signal, or the values that I am going to get, the amplitude values, we are going to call it as discrete values. So such kind of quantization process now we are looking at. Coming to the very first concept, it is the pulse code modulation, wherein we have told that this is nothing but it is going to be the output of a uniform linear quantizer. So the pulse code modulation is an encoding process which has been done for an quantized signal. So now if we want to look at this pulse code modulation, is each quantized sample is digitally encoded into how many bits? Into L bit code word, where capital L is the number of quantization levels. So how do we code a given quantized sample? So we code it as L to be equal to log capital L to base 2. So what is this L? So this capital L is nothing but it is going to tell us what is that quantization level is about. Now let us consider an analog signal x of t, which is limited from the range plus minus 4 here to plus 4. So the range of the voltages that it is going to exist is between minus 4 to plus 4 volt. So the step size of each of the quantization level is set to be 1 volt. So the step size, if you consider here, it is set to be 1 volt. That is, from 3 to 4 it is 1 volt, 2 to 3 it is 1 volt. So like that we have kept the uniform step size here of 1 volt. Then the 8 quantization levels are employed. So which are the quantization levels? So we have given the quantization levels here. So those quantization levels are what? So one is minus 3.5, 2.5, 1.5, 0.5, minus 0.5. So it starts from actually minus 3.5 and goes up to 3.5 volt. Then after setting these quantization levels, what is the next process that we have to do is we have to assign a code number for such levels. So now how do we assign the code numbers? So the code numbers here are assigned from the lower level, that is from the negative value. For minus 3.5, the code number we are trying to code as 0. For minus 2.5, 1. Minus 1.5, it is 2. So on up to, for 3.5, it is 7. So whenever the quantization level 3.5 comes into picture, it means we are trying to code the value which is 7. So then after doing this, if you can look at the below lines, so these each code number has its own binary representation, binary arithmetic representation, which is like 000 for the code number 0 and 111 for code number 7. So those representations we are now going to do for this analog signal x of t which we have considered here. What we have to consider is, or what we have to know here is, why is that we are trying to code it as 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Instead of that, we can actually push this signal x of t in almost all the positive integer sites like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. But what is that we are trying to do? We are trying to have one more voltage level as minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. So what is that thing? It is governing this kind of choosing this kind of usage of zero level or symmetricity about the zero. First is the choice of voltage level is basically guided by two constraints. First is the quantile interval between the levels should be equal. Yes, the quantile level between the intervals is equal. It is 0.5, 0.5. And then second thing is, it is convenient for levels to be symmetrical about 0, and that is where we have to choose this voltage level starting from minus 4 and going up to 4 volts. Then now looking at the diagram, we have each sample of the analog signal is assigned to the quantization level closest to the value of the sample. So the signal has got different sample values, which is shown below here. One is the natural sample value, then the quantized sample value, code number and the PCM sequence. So now if we try to look at the point here where it is marked 1.3 in natural sampling, but in quantized sample value, 1.3 is very close to the quantized level 1.5. So we are trying to map that 1.5 as 1.3 as 1.5. And for 1.5, if we look at the corresponding code number, it is how much? 5. So the PCM sequence for 5 is what? 101. Or the binary equivalent value of the code number is what? 101. So likewise, if we try to look at another case where the natural sample value is 0.7 here, and the quantized sample, though it is very nearer to 0.5, though it is very near to 1, we are not going to take that 1. Instead, we are going to take the closest quantized level value, which is 0.5, and 0.7 is now taking up the quantized sample value as 0.5, and for 0.5 the corresponding code is what? It is 4, and binary representation of 4 is 100. So that is how we are going to generate the PCM sequence for all the quantized points that we are considering symmetrically about the zero axis. What we have actually seen in the previous example is, we have tried to assign the value to each sample out of those 8 levels or a 3-bit PCM sequence. Suppose now I have an analog signal which is a musical passage or some music, say suppose, which is sampled at the Nyquist rate. And then suppose that when we try to listen to that music in digital form, it sounds terrible. Like sometimes it is going to go for a high pitch, sometimes it is going to go for a too lower pitch of zero. So sometimes we will be able to hear the tone and at the other time it will be zero. Absolutely it is not going to be present. So how do we improvise this kind of fidelity? So let us recall the process of quantization, which replaces the true signal with an approximation. So true signal with an approximation means we are trying to add the quantization noise. So that is one thing, which is like, how do we can actually get back our original analog signal is by increasing the number of levels, that is try to reduce the quantization noise, or increase the number of levels of the quantization noise. And then if we double the levels to 16, what are the cases that we can try to be possibly feasible we can look at those kinds of things. And one more thing is increase the number of bits per pulse code modulation sequence, and then the data rate is thus increased, which in turn has a greater effect on the transmission bandwidth. Why it is going to be costlier, or why it is going to cost us? In real-time communication system, the message must be delayed. Hence, if I try to transmit using the transmission time for each sample, it must be same regardless of how many number of bits I am trying to represent and transmit of that particular sample. Hence, when there are more bits per sample, the bits must move at a faster rate. In other words, they must be replaced by skinnier bits. Skinnier bits means very closely placed bits, and that increases the data rate. If it is going to increases the data rate, that it also increases the cost in a greater transmission bandwidth. So everything is linked here. How many sample bits per samples we are considering, how fast the bits are moving, and how much data rate it is being allowed for each such kind of bits to get transmitted. So how much bandwidth expansion has to be done in order to transmit more number of data. So that's where the greater transmission leads to, leads us or costs us more. Some communication systems can be tolerable to the time delay, so that the more quantization levels need not be of more bandwidth. Which means, for example, if you want to transmit a planetary image from a spacecraft, so when that comes into picture, any excess signal which is going, it may take too many several years for a spacecraft to transmit the image from itself to the ground station. So in such kind of cases, the cost of more quantization level and greater fidelity need not be the bandwidth, it can be the time delay here. So the time delay is sometimes a constraint and sometimes the bandwidth. So if it is from the outer stations, like outer space communication, then it is going to be the time delay which is going to be a constraint. And if it is well within the earth and we are trying to transmit some music file, video files, it is going to be the bandwidth which is going to be a constraint. So now we are moving on to the topic, which is uniform and non-uniform quantization. So let us try to understand what is this uniform and non-uniform quantization. So we are trying to take an example of statistics of a speech amplitude. So where in speech communication, we already know it is very much important, and it is one of the specific area of digital communication. So we have unique statistical properties of the speech signal. So the x-axis here, it is representing the speech signal magnitudes in RMS values, and the y-axis here is representing the probability that the speech signal is going to occur is being represented. So now let us have a look at how does we try to understand, or how does we try to get the cases. For most voice communication channels, very low speech volumes are predominant, which means for most of the communication channels, low speech volumes means from the other side, if a person is going to speak in a very low tone, it is not heard by the another party. So that is one of the major thing which is present, which is not always, but it is 50% of the time we have such kind of things. That is, the voltage characterizing detected speech energy is less than 1/4 the times of RMS value. And then for large amplitude values are relatively rare, only 15% of the time does the voltage exceed the RMS value. So sometimes we will have the very good hearing capability of the signal that is being transmitted, and sometimes we will have only 15% of the time the hearing being done of the signal. when we have the step size, steps are uniform in size, the quantization is known as uniform quantization. Whenever the step size of a signal is uniform, step size, if it is uniform, we call such a quantization as uniform quantization. Such a kind of quantization is uniform quantization. And coming for non-uniform quantization, before we go for non-uniform quantization, we have some systems which would be wasteful for sweet signals. Many of the quantization steps would rarely be used. Suppose if we go for uniform quantization, if I try to have the quantization levels been drawn for each of the signal that is present, sometimes the rest of the amplitudes of the quantization levels may be wasteful for such kind of speech signals. So what we do is, in a system that uses usually spaced quantization levels, the quantization noise is same for all signal magnitudes. So therefore, the uniform quantization, the signal to noise ratio is worse for low level signals than for high level signals. So the SNR for uniform quantization is less. SNR for uniform quantization is very, very less, whereas SNR for for weak signal, if I say, it is going to be more. So it is like, how do we consider, how do we choose that we are trying to go for a non-uniform or we are trying to go for a uniform kind of quantization? Now that is what we have to now try to look about. So let me repeat, in any system, if we are trying to use equally spaced quantization levels, the quantization noise is the same for all signal magnitudes. Therefore, what we have to do in uniform quantization, the SNR is very less for low level signals than for high level signals, which means for high level signals, the SNR is of greater value. Now let us move to the next one, which is non-uniform quantization. So what is this non-uniform quantization, where the step size are not equal, where the quantization intervals are not equal? So this can provide a fine quantization of the weak signal. So what is that, how is that it is going to provide the fine quantization for the weak signals and coarse quantization for the strong signals? Let us look at in this particular diagram. So if you can look at, there are two signals has been considered, one is a strong signal and one more is a weak signal. On the leftmost side, we have the uniform quantization being done, uniform quantization process being done for a strong signal. For a strong signal, it is not losing much of the information, wherein we can say signal is being reconstructed back, or we are trying to allocate the proper values for the signal in case of strong signal. But when we comes for weak signal, you can see that unnecessarily the weak signal strength or some of the points are missing out in this particular region. So in this region, if I have non-uniform levels, then it would be really good for me to have more amount of signal been reconstructed than the noise component. So that is where we are trying to move towards non-uniform quantization. So there is nothing much effect on the strong signal when I make use of uniform quantization or I make use of non-uniform quantization. But when it comes for weak signals, the weak signal is actually losing out some of the information here, or it is being not coded, or it is being not pulse coded, or it is not represented in the form of a PCM wave. So that is where we have to move for non-uniform quantization in order to pick up each and every amplitude of the weak signal. So that is what is done in the non-uniform quantization. So when we compare both of them, when SNR, when a strong signal is existing, it is left to the user whether we apply with the uniform or non-uniform quantization. Whenever the weak signal comes into picture, we need to be very careful. So we need to make use of the non-uniform quantization. Now let us understand the quantizer characteristics. Sorry for the heading being overlapped with the image. Then moving on to what is this quantizer characteristics, we are trying to look at the non-uniform quantizer characteristics. So one way that we achieve non-uniform quantization, or how do we get the non-uniform quantization, is by making use of non-uniform quantizer, which is as shown in our this particular figure A, right? So we have such a waveform which is being represented. So what we do is, now non-uniform quantization is achieved by first distorting the original signal with the logarithmic compression characteristics. So when we compress this given original signal with the help of a logarithmic characteristics, so we are going to have a curve nature of the signal which is compressed, instead of having a straight line or a linear line which is non-compressed format. So this compressed characteristics for small magnitude of signals, the compression characteristics has a much steeper slope than for large magnitude signals. Thus a given signal change at small magnitudes will carry the uniform quantizer through more steps than the same change at large magnitude. Since this is there, if you can see here, we have small changes of the quantization, then larger changes. Instead of having this kind of things, what I will do is I will try to distort this particular given signal. And when I distort, I am going to actually compress that distortion, in the sense I am going to compress that using the logarithmic compressor. So when I compress that, I am going to get a signal which is of this type. So when I try to trace that compressed signal, I am going to get the small magnitudes of the uniform quantizer, or all the steps which I am going to cover here is, though there are more number of steps, which are going to be uniformly spaced. So the compression characteristics effectively changes the distribution of the input signal magnitude, so that there are no low magnitude signals present at the output of the compressors. So why do we need such kind of characteristics is because we have to follow what is called as compressing, expanding, and then transmitting the signal. From the transmitter end or from the non-uniform quantizer end, whatever the discrete values will be there, we will first compress it, then uniform quantize it, and then digitally transmit those things over the channel. And at the receiver end, these digitally transmitted signals has to be decoded and then expanded and then taken as an output. So that is what we are trying to do here. One such process is, we are trying to compress it and then uniformly quantize it at the transmitter end. Vice versa is done, or the exact opposite operation is done at the receiver end, that is decoding of the uniform quantized signal and then expanding the signal to get back the original quantized signal. So this kind of process we will be carrying over in any of the transmission system which is available in baseband signal or digital signal transmission. Moving on, for what should be the compression characteristics, what are the characteristics that we have to consider? So the PCM systems, which was implemented as a smooth logarithmic compression function in the previous slide, Now this PCM system use a piecewise linear approximation. So what is this piecewise linear approximation? Is it makes use of a which is similar to or which is almost equal to the logarithmic compression characteristics. So in North America we have what is called as mu law compression, which is as shown here for the first representation, and in European countries we have what is called as A law compression, which is as shown here. This is basically done to transmit the data at the fastest rate within the given bandwidth. So we have the mu law compression, which is given here as y. Y is equal to y max log of 1 plus mu into magnitude of x by x max. So before we get into this, what is the signum of x is? For all the values of x greater than or equal to 0, signum of x is going to take up the value plus 1, and for all the values of x to be greater than or less than 0, for x value greater than or equal to 0, signum of x is going to be plus 1, and for the other values of x less than 0, it is going to be minus 1. So this will be the function for your signum of x, and where mu here, this mu is going to be a positive constant, and then x and y represents input and output voltages, and x max and y max are maximum positive input and output voltages respectively. So this kind of technique is used in Northern America. So the standard value of mu is 255 in North America. So let us go back to the graph and look at how this graph is going to help us to understand. So now you can see, for mu to be equal to 0, we have a linear straight line. Mu to be equal to 1, mu to be 5, mu is equal to 100, and mu is equal to 255. Depending on this, we can increase the number of we can actually try to compress the number of bits in a smaller value and then transmit those bits. So now in North America, if mu is equal to 255, it means that it is accommodating more number of bits and then transmitting so many number of bits. Likewise for European countries, I said we are going to make use of A law, which is as defined. So it has got A, which is a positive constant, x and y are again the input and output voltages, and this A law compression which is used in European countries, the standard value here is going to be 87.6. The subjects of uniform and non-uniform quantization for your A law, which is the standard value, is 87.6, which is maximally used till date. More than that, it has been not yet used in the European countries. So that is about the compression of signals or compression of non-uniform quantized signals and then transmitting those bits further. Then moving on to the next topic, we have baseband signaling. Before we move to that, let us quickly recap that what is compression, what is that we have studied, or let us summarize here. So the very first concept is, what are these pulse code modulated signals, and then we moved on to the quantization, how quantization is done, and then non-uniform and uniform quantization, quantization characteristics, and then compressions, the two types of compressions, one is mu law compression and A law compression. Hope you all enjoyed. Thank you.